I had to get rabies shots for biting the head off a bat, but that's okay. The bat had to get Aussie shots. What's the deal? Cody from the Cody on Chain NFT YouTube channel back with another one. And today we're going to start it off right. I'm going to go over a couple NFT projects that you want to know about. And we'll start with the legend, Ozzy Osbourne himself with CryptoBatz. Hey, if you don't know Ozzy Osbourne, you might be just a little bit too young to watch this channel. This man is an absolute legend. The epitome of a rock star, and only what, about a week ago, December 27th, he announced the launch of CryptoBatz, which is an NFT project with 9,666 in the collection. So we have Ozzy as the creative director. I'm assuming that he doesn't have too much to do with the day-to-day ins and outs of the project. You know, he's not doing the art, he's not doing the tokenomics, he's not doing the game theory, but you know, he's the face of the project. He's what's going to get people excited because the rest of the team, pretty undocs, you know, but apparently they have some pretty good track records behind them. I reached out to them, and if I hear back from them, they got some more inside info for me. I'm going to let you guys know. But for now, just know that they're an undocs team, but it says that they've worked with former celebrities in the past. They've worked with teams like Nike. So, you know, it looks like they know what they're doing because they got a couple of pretty cool ideas in their roadmap. Okay, at the very top, you see some very important things. You see Story, Mutant Bats, Ancient Bats, Roadmap Team and FAQ. So let's dive into what the heck a mutant bat is. Mutant bats feast on the flesh of other NFTs. We wanted CryptoBatz to do something new, something that wasn't easy, something that we hadn't seen before. Every CryptoBat holds an innovative power, the ability to bite an NFT from a different blue chip project and create a mutant bat that shares the DNA of both tokens. Every CryptoBat can bite once and once only, so choose carefully as what you choose to bite will dictate which mutant bat you create. If you want to bite your victim project, you must hold both the CryptoBat and the victim in the same wallet. Biting utility will open soon after the public mint. So far, the three partner projects that you can bite to mutate your mutant bats are Bored Ape Yacht Club, Cryptodes, and Supducks. You can see this bat right here, he kind of got that ape looking face to him. Here's a GIF real quick, just rolling through the art, which it looks pretty cool. They said something about, hey, our art's all designed with the golden ratio. That's something very important to them. I know that they talked about it somewhere on the website, and we're just gonna go and find it because it's right here. Dark creatures with the golden ratio, you can see, boom. Every crypto bat trait has been creatively directed by Ozzy Osbourne. Unlike some of Ozzy's previous bat friends, these ones live safely in the metaverse and are not edible yet. Please tell me that you remember, and you know, and you're old enough to remember, Ozzy bit the head off a bat. That's why I started the video with that little sketch thing, because that's him. That's the GOAT Ozzy Osbourne. Mutant bats are actually a pretty cool concept. It's innovative. I haven't heard somebody doing that yet. But then they have something called ancient bats, right? They're going to have an IRL treasure hunt. They even show that they're going to have an interactive map saying, hey, you're close to it. Ancient bats are able to bite up to 99 times, granting them an unrivaled power to each breed 99 mutant bats. Ancient bats are each custom designed by some of the most renowned artists in the world, meaning that beyond utility, the holder also possesses a piece of extremely rare art. One example of this is the fact that Gremlin, you know, one of the most popular NFT artists around, decided to create three legendaries for this project, and they even show you two of them right here. So this is the art from Gremlin. We've scattered ancient bats around the world in hidden locations. They could be up a mountain, deep in a forest, underwater, or even stuck in the ceiling of a dive bar toilet. The common theme, they're not easy to find. They're going to gradually release hints so that you can basically say, hey, wow, nobody's finding our ancient bats yet. We kind of want to make it a little bit easier. They're going to be giving more hints to people that are more involved in the community. So it's a good way to kind of gamify engagement, make sure people are interacting with the project and making sure that other people say from the outside, damn, that looks like a fun community. Everyone's having a good time going on treasure hunts. I want to get in on that. The only thing we know for sure is the collection size of 9,666. And we have a mint price of 0.088 Ethereum. But we do not have a release date yet. This is a brand new project. They just were announced a week ago, so we're very early to the game. Right now, though, you can already see that if you go to their Twitter account, they have about 25,000 followers. And on their Discord, it's already pretty popping with about 40,000 members in there. So that's CryptoBatz. And real quick, before I dive into the next project, if you like these type of videos, please show me by clicking that like button. Just click it. The next project I want to talk to you about is Cops Game. One thing, if you've been around the channel, you know how much we love crypto gaming. We love the way that people combine DeFi and crypto to make us money. The video I recorded yesterday was a complete tier list of all the biggest NFT projects. And one project very similar to this that we're about to get into was Wolf Game. If you want to have an idea of see how highly ranked I put Wolf Game, check out that video above. Cops Game, or Cops and Robber, is Solana's version of Wolf Game. For anyone that isn't acquainted with Wolf Game and the interaction and what happened, I'll briefly talk about the mechanics of the game. So to start off, you're going to mint. There's a 10,000 Genesis collection, there's 9,000 robbers and 1,000 cops. If you mint a robber, what you're going to do is you stake your robber and every single day they're going to collect loot for you. But the cops actually collect a tax on the loot. So 20% of all the loot that robbers make goes directly to the cops as a bribe to not steal loot from them. But the cool thing that makes this very exciting is there's a huge risk factor. Not only that do they tax it, but there's a 50% chance of cops arresting you and taking all your loot. Confiscated loot is split amongst all the cops currently staked in the syndicate, proportional to their rank. So what's going to happen is if you're a robber, you'll be making money, but cops can steal everything from you. So how it works is cops don't get staked for passively receiving loot, but what they do, they get the 20% tax, but you also get a chance of robbing robbers of their loot. There's different ranks of cops, and the higher the rank of the cop, the bigger proportion of the loot that's stolen do they get. Same with the tax. Also, the higher rank cops have a much higher chance of stealing completely from the robbers. The equivalent of cop game in the Ethereum network is Wolf Game. And Wolf Game is absolutely flying. We have people like Gary Vaynerchuk. Beanie went full-time. I'm pretty sure he stepped down from Pixel Vault to pretty much exclusively talk about Wolf Game. And their wolves, which are their version of cops, they just had a wolf sell for over 50 Ethereum. They've had a demon wolf sell for over 80 Ethereum. The wolves and the cops are much more valuable than the sheep and the robbers, but both of them play their role and you make money either way. Like I said, Gary Vaynerchuk is super interested in this game. This game has been fun to watch, paper hands within days, fascinating to watch. Too much day trading DNA is leaving some people to miss out on stuff. Use 22 to test patience on something you believe in. Gary's bought a ton. I keep seeing him buy different wolves. He's buying sheep. He's buying wool, the token that is the equivalent to loot. This is a very big game. It's going to make a ton of money, but I think people are going to get slowly priced out of the Ethereum version, right? You know, you're spending 8-9 ETH just for the wolves. You're spending 1-3 ETH for the sheep. You know, not everybody has that kind of money. So why not take a lower percent of your income, right? Way cheaper to get in on Solana for your version of Cops Game, which is pretty much taking the very cool mechanics that they created, the game theory, but in a cheaper version. Two people I really respect in this space are Easy Eats Bodega and Wappy. What Easy Eats said is, I cannot wait for Cops Game on the 6th. 1.25 Sol may be pricey, but the team has nailed the testing of what looks like a legit Wolf Game on Sol. And Wappy says, I want in. Those two people I do follow, I do trust. And you know what? If they're into it, I'm into it. So right here, the team explains the game a little bit more. You can stake your robbers and cops to earn loot. Robbers earn 10,000 loot per day, and cops earn a 20% tax on all robber loot production. These are the Gen 0 cops and robbers. Then they're going to have Gen 1 cops and robbers that you can mint using the loot token. Currently, robbers will be generating 0.5 Sol a day in loot, and cops on average 1.8 times the robbers. So just to start out, that's before the game even takes off, robbers at current price are going to be making about 100 USD a day in loot passively, and robbers are going to be making almost $200 a day just to start off. This is not financial advice, but I am personally all in on this game. I just moved a good bit of Solana to my Phantom wallet. Also, let me show you something else that's going to get you very excited about what we got moving forward. Something that's really cool is that it's still kind of a smaller project. If you look at their Twitter account, they only have about 5,700 followers, but it is going up fast. When I started doing research for this video, only about an hour ago, they had 5,000. And their Discord's up to about 21.5 for members and 21,000. When I started researching this about an hour ago, it was at just about 20,000. So it is moving up fast, but you're still kind of early. Not a ton of people engaged with this project. But the mint date is in 3 days, January 6th. But the cool thing that I wanted to show you is that they're going to have 3,000 whitelist spots. And they only currently have 1,100 people whitelisted. And all you got to do for a whitelist spot, if you click on their whitelist guide, is you go to this whitelist form, not the picture of it, the link of it, and you just fill it out. You invite 3 people to Discord, which obviously, you know, we don't want to have these invite games, but I do like the game. I do really like this project. And I think that, you know, something that could price you out of Wolf Game, if it's a little bit too expensive for you, this is a great alternative. I'm so excited for 2022. I love the fact that we're getting all these crazy, really innovative projects right off the bat to start the year. I just can't wait to see where the year takes us. So I appreciate you watching. If you haven't yet, subscribe to the channel, and I'ma see you later.